En culture.
President, please be seated.
Président, veuillez vous asseoir.
En culture.
The court is now back in session.
Reprise de l'audience.
And I'd like to hand the floor to the lead co-lawyers for civil parties
la parole est donnée au
for their key document presentation. You may proceed.
Leur document clé. Vous avez la parole.
Good afternoon, Mr. President, Your Honours, parties, civil parties, and everyone in and around the courtroom. I'd like to make my key document presentation regarding
the présentation sur les documents clés relatifs
treatment against the Cham people. The first document that I refer to is
que j'aimerais faire référence est le document
E3/6718, which is a civil party application of Matkar with the Khmer EN
portant
at 0056355260. And there is no English translation, although the translation into English was requested through ITU. And allow me to quote
je vais citer
the excerpts from this civil party applicant.
De cette demande de constitution de
I am Matke. My current address is in Phung Di Pram Village, Svai Klang Commune, Krochma District,
Kampong Cham.
On the event of the rebellion by Svai Klang villagers, Phung Di Pram. When the Khmer Rouge took control of Phnom Penh in 1975, people who lived in the cities were evacuated to rural areas. The elderly were carried by horse carts to villages, approximately 10 people per cart, and there were 4 to 5 carts in
total.
I do not know where the Khmer Rouge, whom I did not know, evacuated them to, but I know that many did not return to the village. I believed all were killed by the Khmer Rouge. The elderly people that the Khmer Rouge took included Li Pat's father, named Li Pat,
qui s'appelait Li Pat,
Ali, and Li Sukai's father, Sun Li, who were killed by the Khmer Rouge.
Qui ont été tués par les Khmer
Rouge. I do not know why the Khmer Rouge killed these elderly people.
Ont tué ces personnes âgées.
I heard from a Khmer Rouge cadre,
j'ai entendu de la bouche d'un cadre Khmer Rouge, qui est homme,
who was Khmer and
qui était lui
security
Khmer
chief of Krochma district,
du district de Krochma,
who said during a meeting that the capitalists had all
capitalistes devaient tous être nettoyés.
However, I did not know who these capitalists were.
Ces capitalistes.
After the announcement, people from the village continued to disappear.
Ont continué de disparaître.
At that time, chief of Phung Di Pram village
le chef
was
a
Khmer Rouge cadre, Mat, and so were the village security chief. As villagers continued to disappear at night,
et j'ai entendu une rumeur au sujet d'un plan des Khmer Rouges
to arrest a group
visant
of 20 villagers.
Un groupe de 20 villageois.
And then, for the second group, they
et
will take 200 more
ils
villagers.
200 autres villageois pour un deuxième
they
groupe.
Already had a plan as whom
ils avaient
they
déjà
would take
prévu
away.
Qui ils allaient emmener.
Having heard that, the elderly people who remained in the village made a plan to rebel against the Khmer rule.
Les plus âgés qui restaient dans le village avaient établi un plan de se révolter contre les Khmer rouges qui eux souhaitaient nettoyer au point de vue ethnique les Cham.
The Khmer rouges mistreated the Cham people more than they abused the Khmer people.
Plus qu'ils maltraitaient les Khmer.
For example,
par exemple,
if a Khmer Islam wanted to go anywhere, they needed to ask for travel permission from the Khmer
rouges.
Otherwise, they could not go.
Sinon, ils ne pouvaient pas y aller.
The Khmer rouges prohibited the Cham people from studying the Quran, and they forced them to study the Khmer language in order to educate the Cham language and literacy.
Et l'alphabétisme Cham.
I believe that was the reason the villagers of Phumthi Pram village revolted.
Les gens du village Phumthi Pram se sont révoltés.
The elderly people in the village plotted a rebellion against the Khmer rouges.
Ont comploté pour se révolter contre les Khmer rouges.
I forget the names of those who involved.
Ceux qui avaient participé.
However, I can recall that there were a man from Krochmar, who is now called Sof Punjamin, as one of the masterminds behind the rebellion against the Khmer rouges.
Des cerveaux de cette révolte.
On the eve of the rebellion, the Khmer Rouge spoke of selecting 20 people to be killed.
Choisir 20 personnes qui allaient être exécutées.
Having heard that, the villagers planned to rebel
cela, les villageois ont prévu
and to prevent the Khmer Rouge from killing the villagers.
De tuer les villageois.
At night time, if the Khmer Rouges called anyone out from their homes, the plan was to close the door and scream loud enough for the nearby villagers to hear.
De leur maison, donc le plan visait à crier très fort pour que les voisins l'entendent.
When hearing the screams, a villager banged the drum as a signal for other villagers to hear.
Si un villageois entendait les cris, il tapait sur son tambour pour que les autres villageois l'entendent.
It was happening. After that, villagers armed with knives and axes went to where the Khmer Rouges were located.
Sont allés là où étaient les Khmer Rouges.
That night, there were many Khmer Rouge people.
Il y avait beaucoup de
the exact number was not known due to
on
darkness.
Ne connaissait pas le nombre exact de Khmer Rouges car il faisait noir.
The villagers fought against the Khmer Rouges, and as a result, a Khmer Rouge cadre named Chet died.
Chet, un cadre Khmer Rouge, est mort.
I joined the rebellion, but I was not at the front line. I was at the third front line because my wife had just given birth.
J'étais pas dans les premières lignes car ma femme venait d'accoucher.
The rebellion lasted two nights and one day, and the Khmer Rouge cadre surrounded the village and ordered the villagers to disarm, and they were evacuated to Wat Dam Chay Pagoda and Wat Kang Chok Pagoda in Dam Chay village, Krochmar commune, Krochmar district, Kampong Cham province. At Wat Dam Chay and Wat Kang Chok Pagoda, the Khmer Rouge separated women and children
et les enfants
to stay separate from the men who were ordered to stay at Ksak Prachek school
in Krochmar district, Krochmar commune,
Kampong Cham province, which was about 1.5 kilometers from Wat Dam Chay and Wat Kang Chok Pagoda. I was detained by the Khmer Rouge at Ksak Prachek school. There were seven members in my family, including my parents, my grandfather, Mat Musa, my younger brother, Mat Sin, my wife,
Sok Man Yan,
and my daughter, Pao Siyas, who was about 2 months old.
Qui avait 2 mois environ.
My mother, my wife, my younger brother,
who was about 19 years old,
and my daughter were all ordered to stay at Wat Tham Tre Pagoda, while my father, grandfather, and I were ordered to stay at Sat Prakhet School, Krochma Commune, Krochma District, Kampong Cham Province. The Sat Prakhet School had three rooms, an eight-room house, about 40 people. Having stayed there about a week,
j'y suis resté environ une semaine.
A Khmer Rouge soldier,
après quoi, un soldat Khmer Rouge,
who was a guard there carrying
a garde,
list,
et avait une liste,
and began calling out names from the list.
À appeler des noms qui figuraient sur cette liste.
In the room where I stayed, the Khmer Rouge called seven people out. I do not remember who, but amongst them were my other brother-in-law and him, and my sister-in-law, Sim Tho.
Et ma belle-sœur,
all were ordered to return home.
De rentrer à la maison.
Having stayed at Sat Prakhet School for about a month,
je suis resté ensuite un mois.
I was released by the Khmer Rouge to meet my wife and children.
Les Khmer Rouge m'ont remis en liberté pour les
and then
ma
we
femme
were
et mes
evacuated to another location.
Vers un autre endroit.
As my mother and my other sister,
comme
if they had met my brother
aînée,
or
si
sister-in-law, they replied that they had not.
On leur a demandé si
so I believe that those on the list.
Et ils ont répondu que non, c'est pourquoi je pense que ceux qui, dont les noms figuraient sur la liste ont tous été tués.
À Sat Prakhet School, the Khmer Rouge abused and starved the villagers.
Les Khmer Rouge ont affamé les villageois. Les Khmer Rouge
a letter of gruel to each person to eat.
De bouillie à chaque personne.
The Khmer Rouge no longer allowed to villagers to bathe two at a time because the school was near the river bank.
De se laver
if
plus
someone
que deux
ran
fois,
slowly, the Khmer Rouge would
si
beat him or her.
La rivière était à côté, si
at that school, the Khmer Rouge closed the doors and
battait.
Windows tightly, keeping light and wind out.
Fermées. Il n'y avait pas de lumière ni de vent ou de brise.
Detainees such as
Merun,
Tesrain,
Softster,
who died in 1999,
morts,
and other villagers whom I do not recall their names,
dont je ne me souviens plus des noms.
After 30 days of detention,
après 30 jours en détention à l'école de Sat
the Khmer Rouge brought rowboats to take the villagers to Chuting Village, unknown commune of Krochma District, Kampong Cham Province. All seven members of my family traveled by boat, and when we arrived at Chuting Village, the Khmer Rouge ordered the villagers to walk to three separate villages,
les ont dit
namely
aux personnes d'habiter dans trois villages, par exemple à Bonte Che, Kei Sambat,
and Dambai,
et Lambai,
in Dambai commune,
dans
Dambai
la
district,
commune de
Kampong
Dambai,
Cham province.
En province de Kampong Cham.
And I will now move on to the second civil party.
Je vais maintenant parler de la deuxième demande de constitution de parti civil.
And I refer to civil party applicant Matt Moussa.
Plutôt, il s'agit de
Matt
Moussa.
0049-98-59.
72
and the French
en
Ian is at
0089-7184.
And the civil party application is E3/6035. The So Patty mentions about the events that also happened in Keyu village in Kampong Cham province, and allow me to read the excerpt from the civil party application as follows. In 1976, Hong Kong introduced the collective eating regime. At the time, Jams suffered difficulties in freedom of expression,
worshipping of our God, and eating. Etc., quand il voulait.
When the Khmerus wanted to mistreat the Cham people, they cooked rice gruel.
Il faisait de la bouillie mélangée à du porc.
For us to eat 2 or 3 times a day, and even the Cham refused to eat the prepared meals, Hong Kong would take them to the security center
for execution.
And if we refused to eat, we had no choice but to starve ourselves. Because we do not have our own kitchen utensils, not even a spoon.
De cuisine, ni même une
and when we were so hungry,
et nous avions tellement faim,
we had to pick up some tree fruits without asking for permission from Hong Kong.
Des fruits plutôt qui tombaient des arbres
and if
sans
that
demander
is the
cash,
then we
et si cela se produisait,
would be punished.
Nous punissait.
Even that. The fruits from the trees we had planted ourselves around the house were not allowed to be picked, let alone the fruits on the trees which belongs to others.
Sans parler des,
especially
on
was known immediately when there was a smoke from any cooking. It had employed a lot of spies, mostly children to spy on us.
De la fumée si on faisait notre propre cuisson, car il y avait des espions partout, notamment des enfants.
And again, I'd like to read some information from the same civil party applicant in
his
supplementary information form, that is document EC-0358A, with the Khmer ERN and 0058-49-03, and English.
En anglais.
0085-82-08 and French
en français,
at 0088-1065. And I'd like to read the following excerpt from the supplementary information form of Mr. Matt
du formulaire d'information complémentaire de Matt Moussin.
3. Persecution of the Cham.
Persecution des Cham.
Between 1975 and 1976, the Khmerus arrested and executed former soldiers
and
17 April people.
Gens du 17 avril.
Khmerus soldiers also called me for questioning about my background. They asked me if I had been a soldier. I said no.
J'ai dit que non.
Yes, at the time, my name had not been entered in their list.
Dans leur registre.
And those who had implicated me
mis en cause
had already been executed by the Khmer Rouge.
Par les Khmer Rouge.
Finally, I was released due to lack of evidence.
On m'a libéré par manque de preuves.
After the executions, there was
après
no classification between the bad people and the new people. During the Khmer Rouge regime, they had me work as a cook.
Sous le régime Khmer Rouge, on m'a fait travailler comme
because
cuisine.
They knew that I was a Cham and that
Cham,
I dare not steal pork, Angkor's pork.
Voler le porc d'Angkor.
They mistreated the Cham people, such as forcing us to eat pork.
Les Cham. Ils nous ont
later, I was
porc.
Tasked with finding fish in the river.
Puis on m'a envoyé
the Khmer Rouge always humiliated us,
constamment
calling us the stateless people who needed to be completely rooted
sans terre
out.
Qui devait être chassé.
And I'd like now to move on to another civil party applicant, which is the supplementary application of LS.
En fait, il s'agit
plutôt he referred to the document
E3/6226A.
The command EN0058441010.
À 11.
English 0118 4.
En anglais 0107 05.
And French.
En français.
01202983 29 83. I'd like to read the following excerpt.
Je vais lire l'extrait.
During the Lunar regime, I was a peasant living in Trabengchu village, Bang commune, Barai district, Kampong Thong province, with my family. In early 1975, the Meru's militiamen evacuated the villagers to Dao village, Batsna commune, Barai district, Kampong Thong province. Religious observance in my village was strongly restricted. For example, we were forced to eat meat collectively in a cooperative, which was under
the eyes
of the militiamen. Sometimes people were threatened to eat the meat.
Pour vous forcer à manger cette viande.
One of my villagers, Tam Som, was
Tam
forced
Som,
to raise pigs, feeding pigs,
a été forcé d'élever des cochons
at the backyard of my house.
Chez moi.
In late 1978, a Khmer Rouge named
Jam
took him away to be killed at night because of his complaints.
En fait, le 78, un Khmer Rouge, Yem, l'a envoyé, l'a emmené pour le tuer la nuit à cause de ses plaintes. Tam Som a été détenu dans la coopérative de Batsna avant d'être tué. J'ai prié en secret pendant environ un an.
When the liberation day was approaching, because I was afraid of being executed, I also witnessed Khmer Rouge mass graves.
J'ai aussi
the Khmer Rouge traited the Khmer people in my village less severely than the Cham.
Les Khmer Rouges ont traité les Khmer dans mon village moins sévèrement que les Cham. Si un Cham disait quelque chose de mal,
he or she was more likely to be punished than the
Khmer
people. I personally think that this kind of treatment was a form of discrimination against the Cham people.
Discrimination contre les Cham.
And I'd like now for, to move to another civil party application, that is Matt Hack.
Celle de Matt Hack.
Document
E3/6725.
There is no English or French translation.
Il n'y a pas de traduction en anglais ni en français.
Although the translation request was made on the 3rd of August 2015.
2015, une requête de traduction.
And allow me to read this document. My name is
Manher.
I am 69 years old. I live in Phnom Kumti Pram village, Svai Klan commune, Kuchma district, Kampong Cham province. I would like to further complain with respect to what happened during the Khmer Rouge as follows. In late August 1975, the Cham people in Kumti Pram village, Svai Klan commune, organized a rebellion against the Khmer Rouge soldiers because they arrested villagers every day and forbade us from practicing our religion and praying. I witnessed my neighbor, named Sam Min, who was being arrested by two Khmer Rouge soldiers. They said that they needed him to go with them quickly.
Ils ont dit qu'ils avaient besoin
after
de,
he
qu'il
got
venir
off
avec eux très rapidement.
Stair from the house
et donc,
and hit the ground.
Arrivé,
his hands were tied behind his back. And he was escorted
maison,
towards the east,
along dos,
with some other villages.
Avec d'autres villages.
And I did not know where they were heading to. The Jam people could no longer tolerate the oppressions and they engaged in the rebellion as a result. I will skip the lengthy information of the civil party applicant and I move to another civil party applicant named Lipat.
Plutôt passer une autre demande de constitution de parti civil, celle de Lipat.
And I'd like to refer to his c'est document with my EN at 0056-3582-84, English 0106-9332, French,
et en français,
01-139851.
And the
ERNs refer to document E3/6719. And I'd like to make the following, read the following excerpts. The event of uprising in
Zweiklang.
2 months after the arrest of my father, there was an uprising in Zweiklang
commune.
After an early uprising in Korpal village,
Pekmui commune,
Krujmar district.
District de Kreuchmann.
2 days before the revolt in Pungti Pram village, Zweiklang commune,
Krujmar
district, Kampong Cham province,
Zweiklang,
I heard people whose names I do not know saying that there was a plan to arrest 50 to 60 more villagers. The news terrified the villagers. They did not know who were going to be arrested by the Khmer Rouge. Having heard of this rumor, the Khmer Rouge started restricting the practice of Islam. They did not allow the Cham people to pray, nor did they allow women to wear the long scarf, that is, the hijab. They also ordered the Cham people to have the Cham women to have short hair, though they know being so contradicted Islamic rules, because women must wear hijabs to hide their long hair. Women, Muslims would be presumed to have committed a sin and go to hell if they breach the Islamic religious rules. The revolt started at 8 p.m. At the start, 20 to 30 villagers started beating the drums in an attempt to call other people to join the revolt. It lasted from 8 p.m. that night until 7 p.m. the next day. Then a number of the Khmer Rouge soldiers who were armed with B-40 rocket launchers and rifles ran up the villages. They then started shooting at the villagers to suppress them. Because all the other villagers just did not have any weapons to confront the Khmer Rouge, a large number of them were shot dead. Those who could make it alive were later arrested. The revolt took place in Pungti Pram village, Zweiklang commune, Krujmar district, Kampong Cham province, and at that time I was just about 15 to 16 years old. I and my elder sister Li Ning and my mother Mat Yong, together with my younger sister Li Sombro and Li Paktak, as well as approximately 1,000 families, were evacuated to Krujmar commune, Krujmar district, Kampong Cham province. The Khmer Rouge separated men, women, and children from their families. The reason the Khmer Rouge separated the men and the women because they accused men from Pungti Pram village of Zweiklang commune as enemies. As for me, I lived with my mother and sisters. And I move on to another civil party applicant.
Une autre demande de constitution de partie civile.
And here I refer to civil party applicant Sokwini. And the document that I refer to is E3/5050 and Khmer EN0056. 5287, English 0106-0089, French 0093-2703-04. Allow me to quote it again. He said that there were no religious practices of any kind. The Khmer Rouge eliminated them all. Muslims were not allowed to wear Muslim attires.
Les prières étaient bannies.
In the same document,
nos habits traditionnels musulmans.
A bit further down, the civil party applicant stated the following: religious practices were strictly forbidden.
Nous n'avions plus du tout le droit de pratiquer notre religion.
My family is Muslim. The Khmer Rouge forced us to eat pork, or at times
ma famille est musulmane, they lied to us by making us eat des fois, ils nous ont porridge menti with en nous pork. Faisant manger de la bouillie avec du porc.
Muslims, especially the young children who could not stand hunger, had to force themselves to eat pork.
Enfin, qui ne pouvaient pas supporter le fait d'être affamés, devaient manger du pain.
Unwillingly, they had to violate
donc,
the rule of their
volonté,
religion.
Ils ont dû violer les commandements de leur religion. Ils nous ont forcé à manger du pain, et si nous ne mangeons pas, alors ils nous ont envoyé à être interrogés par des officiers de plus haut rang.
In other words, we would be killed. Some people agreed to eat, while others did not. They would share 200 grams of pork to each of us, and paid a militiaman spied on us to see whether we
un milicien, c'est-à-dire un espion pour voir si nous mangeons ou non. Certains musulmans ont échangé le porc contre du sel.
Strong for me about Dambadang Rodwini, Chong Krai,
and I want to move on to the information of the last civil party applicant related. In relation to the treatment of the Cham people, that is a document E3/4892 with Khmayan at 0054-0804-206 and English at 0089-0956257. And French at 0089-4003. I'd like to make the following quote. I am Ahmad, male, currently living in Phum Pram village, Swai Klam commune, Krochma district, Kampong Cham province. I would like to make the following complaints. One, the ban on Islamic practice. The Khmer Rouge entered my village since 1970. Only in 1975 did the Khmer Rouge begin to repress the people. High-ranking people in the village were arrested by the Khmer Rouge in 1973, including my father.
Y compris mon père.
He was arrested in 1973 and had since disappeared.
Et depuis, il a disparu.
My father's name was
Manhak. S'appelait Manhak.
In late 1975, the Khmer Rouge banned
les Khmer
praying
ont interdit
of our Allah, and women had to keep their hair short,
femmes,
which was a violation of the
ce
Islamic religion. They prohibited
musulmane.
Us from speaking
ils
the Cham language.
Cham.
Two, suppressing a revolt by Cham people.
De
in late 1975, perhaps in September,
fin 1975, peut-être en septembre,
1975, which was almost the end of the Ramadan, people in my village began to revolt against the Khmer Rouge mistreatment. Before the revolt, arrests had been made constantly, which explained why the people joined the revolt. The people in Swai Kleang used machetes and axes in protest. They arrested and killed a Khmer Rouge member, Chet, a Khmer citizen working in Swai Kleang commune. Then the Khmer Rouge came to surround Swai Kleang village. Men were arrested and taken to a tobacco warehouse located to the west of Prey Tadung Bridge in Kruchma commune. I was also detained at a tobacco kiln, while women were taken to pagodas and temples. At the tobacco warehouse, I received only two small bowls of thin gruel for each meal, or twice a day. The food was not sufficient.
La nourriture n'était pas suffisante.
I was detained there for about 20 days.
At
the warehouse, I saw the Khmer Rouge
beat
and persecute the people. I remember that the Khmer Rouge beat a man named Man and another villager, Lo, who was ill, who was taken to get treatment at the hospital and has since disappeared. At the kiln, the Khmer Rouge screened the personal histories of those who were involved in the revolt. Later, I was evacuated again and again to do farming until 1979, when I returned to my village. I conclude my part, Mr. President. I'd like to cede the floor to my international colleague. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to thank my colleague and thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon to all of you.
I have five documents that I'd like to present linked to five civil parties which were all
admitted under the heading the treatment of the charm. And I'd like to focus essentially on the information linked to the facts that the chamber is seized of regarding forced transfer, population transfer 2. And I will start with another document linked to the civil party which my colleague just spoke about, Mr. Hakmat, who is from Swai Kleang.
Et je me réfère
and
ici au
I am referring here to document E3/48-93,
ERN en anglais
English ERN 00085-1-2-6-3-6-5,
ERN en français 00-09-05-1-5-4 et 1-5-5,
and 1-5-5, Khmer ERN 00-5-7-8-1-3-3-2-8-1-3-6.
À l'intention des interprètes, je vais lire le premier paragraphe de ce document,
of this document
où il est indiqué,
where
et je
it
cite,
is stated, and I quote,
après une sélection des biographies,
after selecting the biographies,
les Khmer Rouges the Khmer ont Rouge évacué ma famille
evacuated my
et un
family
grand
and a great number of cham,
dont aucun
and none of them was connected to any kind of rebellion. However, in village 4, in Prek Achi commune,
district de
Kruchma district,
province de Kampong Cham
province.
À cette époque,
and back then,
les Khmer Rouges, non inconnus, ne donnèrent pas de raison
did not provide
pour
any reason for this evacuation.
Ils se contentèrent de nous rassembler sur un bateau
gathered us on a boat
qui nous transporta
that transported
au village
us
4
to village 4,
escortés par de jeunes hommes de la milice.
By young men from the militia.
À l'arrivée dans ce village, ma famille, c'est-à-dire moi-même, ma femme et nos trois enfants,
my wife and my
avons
three
habité sous le même toit qu'une brave femme Khmer
âgée
qui s'appelait Thor. C'était la fin 1975. Il indique ensuite
and then he
au paragraphe
in paragraph,
suivant
in the following paragraph,
il y eut un deuxième
transfert
et on nous transporta par bateau jusqu'à Stung Trang.
Transported us by boat all the way to Stung Trang.
Au début,
at the beginning, they said that they were taking us to Battambang.
À l'arrivée à
and when we arrived in Stung Trang, however,
certains
Cham, some Cham people were transferred to Kompong Tom,
alors que d'autres,
whereas
dont
others
ma famille,
in my family
allèrent au village
went
de Sopias,
to Sopias village, which was located in
Sopia,
Sopias commune,
du district de Stung Trang,
Stung Trang district,
dans la province de Kompong Cham.
Kompong Cham province.
Une autre partie civile de Zweig Kling, qui est aujourd'hui décédée
et
qui s'appelle Li Taem,
her name is Li Taem,
a eu le même parcours que Hakmat après
the same fate as
la répression de la rébellion.
The rebellion was
il a
crushed.
Transité par
he went
Prek
through
Prek
Chi,
et je me réfère ici à son
document
E3/67/15. Aux ERN en Khmer,
Khmer
00056-4253-5-5. ERN en français,
01-20-30-07
jusqu'à 08, avec une traduction en anglais
translation
qui a été demandé,
which was requested.
Et cette partie civile
and this civil party
explique de manière plus précise
in
a
more detailed way
de
in
civile,
his supplementary information form
E3
of his application at E3/67/15a
ERN en Khmer,
Khmer ERN 00058 59 4 0 2 4 1
ERN en anglais
011 84 7 3 6
et en français 01 20 30 67 30 67. Les conditions
and,
de vie et les mesures réservées
aux Cham dans le
district de Stung Trang après avoir été évacué.
Evacuated,
il indique, et à l'intention des interprètes, je suis donc dans le chapitre qui s'intitule Persécutions religieuses, il indique, et je cite,
and he indicates, and I quote,
en 1977, je suis arrivé au village de
Sampia,
commune de Stung Trang,
Stung Trang
province
commune,
de Kompong Cham,
Kompong Cham province,
où les Khmer Rouges
where the Khmer Rouge forced the Cham
à manger de la
to
viande
eat
de porc.
Pork meat.
Et à chaque fois,
time,
ils envoyaient
they
deux ou trois miliciens
two to three militiamen
dont je ne connaissais pas l'identité,
whose identity I did not know, to watch over us in order to see that if we were indeed eating that pork meat.
En fin de compte, aucun Cham n'osait jamais protester, sinon ils nous exécutaient.
To protest, otherwise we would be
et
executed.
Il indique un petit
peu plus loin, à la fin down,
de ce chapitre sur la persécution religieuse,
religious
j'ai
persecution.
Vu les Khmer Rouges ordonner aux femmes Cham,
order the Cham women,
dont j'ai oublié le nom,
whose name I forgot,
d'aller nourrir des cochons.
To go feed pigs.
Dong a forcé
Ta'el,
décédé,
who is deceased,
à prendre soin des cochons
take
dans
care
le village.
Of the pigs in the village.
Les Khmer Rouges
the Khmer
du village,
in the village
interdisaient absolument la prière
forbade,
et la communication en langue Cham sous peine d'exécution.
Language,
malgré
the threat of execution.
Nous avons parfois
however,
pu le faire
sometimes
en cachette.
We were able to do so in secret,
j'ignore
and I
pourquoi les Khmer Rouges
do not know
ont ainsi réprimé
Khmer Rouge
la religion
repressed,
de Cham.
The Cham religion in this
la
way,
vie sous les Khmer Rouges
life
était vraiment
under
difficile.
The Khmer Rouge was very, very harsh.
La dernière partie civile
and the last
dont je
civil
souhaitais
party,
citer le document,
whose document I'd like to mention,
et qui
and,
vient de
Zweig Kling,
et Sos
Mostot,
qui avait 15 ans
was 15
en 1975,
and I'm referring
ici
here
document
to document
E3/67/16, ERN en français
French ERN
020,
020 20, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30,
14, ERN en Khmer, 00, 56, 35, 17, jusqu'à 22, traduction en anglais, demandée et non encore reçue.
Was requested, but the document has not yet been translated.
Cette partie civile,
and this civil party who also was detained in Poprok Pagoda, which my colleague spoke about, indicates regarding the transfer of her family.
And here I am
in the middle of the page in the French version.
Par la suite, later on, the Khmer Rouge
took my family and the other villagers into a boat
et nous ont convoyés jusqu'au village
transported
de Rokoknol,
Rokoknol commune
de Kreutzmar
district,
Kampong-Cham
province.
Je me souviens avoir été évacué en même temps
at the same time as Lisuki's family.
Il indique and he indicates dans la phrase d'après,
in the following sentence,
nous avons vécu dans le village de Rokoknol pendant 2 ans,
for 2 years, I believe.
Dans cette région, je devais faire paître de bœufs au sein d'une équipe dont le chef s'appelle Prey,
qui est d'ailleurs mort depuis. Prey, who since
je ne connaissais
has
pas
died.
Le chef
I did not know the chiefs, the village chiefs,
d'équipe
or
ou
the
de coopérative.
Team chiefs or, the cooperative
dans
leaders.
Ce village, in this village, the Khmer Rouge
did not force the Cham people to eat pork meat,
mais ils nous interdisaient
but they
de parler
forbade
Cham,
us to speak
de
the Cham language,
la religion musulmane,
to practice our Muslim religion,
et de laisser pousser
and,
les cheveux longs.
To let us grow our hair long.
J'ai deux autres
so I have two other civil party applications linked to the Cham, but I'm looking at my colleague because I think that we also have documents to present regarding the treatment of the Vietnamese. So I'm going to speed up. Two civil parties who both were admitted under the section of the treatment of the Cham, and they were transferred one from
Kampong Sim district
to Cham Ka Leu district. And I'm referring here to document
Lip.
The document of civil party Sat Lip, and this is document E3/68116,
small a.
This is the supplementary information form of Sat Lip civil party application. Khmer ERN 00588463-65,
French ERN 00860859-860860,
and English ERN 00853-9984-2985.
Salip
was 26 years old in 1975,
indique,
and he indicates, and here I'm speaking about the second paragraph of the document of the supplementary information form
je
here,
cite,
and I quote for translation,
in 1975,
there were
sept
seven members in my family.
Ma femme,
there
Matt
were me,
Amnas,
my wife,
deux
Matt,
fils,
Amnas, two sons,
Lip
Pukri
et Lip
Sulsari.
Trois filles,
and my three daughters,
Lip Famas, Lip Safias, et Lip Sreifas,
et moi-même.
Myself. Ma famille vivait alors dans le village de Ronia, commune de Sambomir, district de
Kampong Sim,
province de Kampong Cham.
This was translated
peu après la victoire des forces armées Khmer Rouge sur l'armée de Lon Nol, des militaires Khmer Rouge inconnus ont ordonné à ma famille, à moi-même et à tous les villageois, ce qui faisait en tout 1000 personnes environ, de quitter ensemble le village d'Elobe et d'aller au village de Kampong Trabai, province de Kampong Cham.
Krabai, Kampong 11:30, Cham province. At 11:30,
we arrived in this village
where the Cham were also living.
Ma famille
and my family
settled
in this region, and the Khmer Rouge ordered us to work in the rice fields.
Et dernier
and last document.
Il s'agit d'une
this is a civil party by the name of Kassim Tolos.
Qui a été who was evacuated
from
Kosotin district, therefore, in Kampong Cham province,
and he was evacuated to Battambang.
And
I'm referring here to document
E3/47-76,
English ERN 00915. 1, 5, 5 9, 4, 2, 4, 2,
ERN en français,
ERN,
0, 0, 0,
0,
1, 0,
6, 0, 6,
33, 10,
10
à 33, 11,
33, 11,
ERN en Khmer,
0, 0, 0, 0, 0
4,
4, 9,
7,
7
1, 1,
2, 1, 2, 1,
jusque
2,
7, 1,
7, 1, 2, 2.
Cette partie civile était très jeune en 1975, was very young in 1975
because she was only 10 years old.
Et elle
and
indique,
she
et
says,
and here
I'm at the first paragraph of the document,
à la chute de Phnom Penh, when Phnom Penh en 1975, les Khmer Rouge ont expulsé ma famille,
expelled my family,
that was made up of eight mes parents,
people, my parents,
mes deux frères aînés,
my two older brothers,
Tolos
and Tolos Sles,
mes deux frères cadets,
two younger brothers,
Tolos Him Tolos
and Tolos Kaup,
ma frère, ma soeur,
and my
cadette,
youngest
pardon,
sister,
Tolos Sreifas, et moi-même,
myself,
du village numéro 13,
commune
de Kosotin, district de
Kosotin,
province de Kampong Cham
province,
et l'ont déporté vers le village de Wat Cheng, province de Battambang
province,
avec de nombreux autres voisins, tels que
Kopsin,
Kopches,
Kopmak.
Après environ deux mois dans le village
months,
de Wat Cheng,
Wat Cheng
province de
Battambang,
les Khmer Rouges,
Rouge,
dont je ne connaissais pas le nom, ont déporté ma famille dans le village de Srakeo, commune de
Srakeo,
province de Battambang
province,
région
5.
Pendant
and
la saison des pluies de l'année 1977, ma sœur cadette, Tolors Sreifas, a souffert de dysenterie et est morte parce qu'elle ne pouvait pas manger suffisamment. J'en ai terminé, Monsieur le Président, sur la présentation complémentaire des documents sur les charmes, et je redonne la parole à mon confrère Ampik, pour qu'il puisse faire une présentation rapide des documents que nous souhaitions présenter sur les traitements réservés aux Vietnamiens. Merci, M. le Président.
The treatment of the Vietnamese. Thank you, Mr. President.
Once again, Mr. President and your honors, I would like to present key documents on the treatment of Vietnamese and another document,
E322/13A.
I will not read his whole document, but I only refer you to the document number E22/13A, said the legal lawyer for civil party. It is about the treatment of our Vietnamese. There are a few civil party applications which I want to present to the chamber, but somehow I will briefly present those documents. The documents mentioned about the treatment of Vietnamese, particularly the husband and wife, as well as the children. The first document is civil party Chen Pile document E3/5900.1. This is an interview of this civil party by the Documentation Center staff member. Ionin Khmer is 003527485 English, 01-13-32-03-05. There is no French translation at the moment. However, we requested the document to be translated into French on 21st August 2015. I will not read the whole excerpt of that document, but only a small portion of his document. The interviewer's name is Wichia.
Wichia est la personne qui interroge.
Let me quote Wichia.
You
went to dig the canal, as you have mentioned, in 1977. At that time, had the Khmer Rouge begun killing the Vietnamese?
Answer.
I don't think that the killing had started yet in
1977.
Which year?
Which year?
Did the Khmer Rouge start to kill the Vietnamese before you went to dig the canal, or did they start to kill them after you had returned from digging the canal? Answer. The killing started only after I returned home. The Khmer Rouge were angry about the Vietnamese invasion, so they began to investigate and search for the Vietnamese. Which year? Did the Vietnamese invade along the border? Answer. I did not see it with my own eyes. Which year? I see. Answer. I saw that some houses in the village were burned down. Which year? After you returned home, the Khmer Rouge started a search for the Vietnamese. Is that correct? Answer. Yes, it is. Which year? How did they begin the search? They began to search for those who were Vietnamese. Those who were Vietnamese. Which year? Did they begin to search the elderly as well as the young people? Anyone who had link to the Vietnamese would be taken away. If the husband was a Vietnamese, he would be taken away. If the wife was a Vietnamese, she would be taken away together with the children. I am now moving to another document. The interview of a civil party, Madame Khun Samut.
D'un entretien avec Madame Khun
document
Samrat,
E3/7211. And this document consists of another number, E3/7586.
La cote E3/586.
And I am now quoting the EON.
Je vous donne les ERN.
EON in Khmer 0035307 1 through 72. And I have no English EON for you, Mr. President, but the friend is 0115-5167. And Danny is the interviewer.
C'est lui qui mène l'entretien.
Let me quote Danny. Did Uncle Khun Mon's wife know that they would be taken away and killed? Answer, yes, she did. Any day there was a meeting, the unit committee talked about the UN. Danny, what did they say?
Summit.
They said that the Vietnamese people were not allowed to live with the Khmer. They had to be collected and cleansed from Khmer. At first, we thought they would send them back to Vietnam. We did not know they were around it. They were rounding them up to take them to be killed. Danny. How did she feel when she learned they were being gathered up?
Samet,
she realized.
Danny,
how did she feel? Was she afraid, crying?
Samet,
she was so frightened that she became pale.
Réponse, elle a eu tellement peur qu'elle est devenue pâle.
And the same document. At EON in Khmer 0035-3073 and French is 0115-5168, English is 0032-4465. Let me quote once again Summit's answers. The next morning, they came to take their children to meet with their mother. I begged them to keep one of them, but they were refused. At that time, my older brother also begged for one, but they recalled him and made trouble for him another at night too. Tamman's older siblings felt so sorry for their nephews, and they asked one to stay with them, but they were refused. All of those children were taken to be killed. They re-educated them and instructed them, saying, why should the Yuan be kept alive to pass on the bloodline? Kill them all, Dani. Did they say that they had killed them all? I mean, yes, they did not keep them alive for fear they would pass on the Yuan bloodline. My brother said that they called him, but they did not call me.
Mon frère a été,
I am now moving to another document, Pai
Sun,
written records of the interview, E3/5632. He made mention about the deportation of Vietnamese out of Cambodia to Vietnam. Document at the year and number in Khmer is 00895161-8. English is at 00678299-300. French 00899197-98. So let me quote as follows. Deportation to Vietnam.
Je cite,
in July 1975, a few days before our transfer deportation to Vietnam, we were told by the Khmer Rouge to prepare to leave. We asked where we were going to go, but they did not let us know. We did not have a right to ask anything. Before they forced us to go back to Vietnam, nothing was said to us about where we had to go. But it was understood that they were trading us for salt to the Vietnamese government. The trade of salt was in exchange for Vietnamese person to be recused by Vietnam. I did not see any salt or rice for my exchange, but I heard about it from others, and I believe that it was true, because if there was no such an exchange program, Vietnamese would not be allowed to go back home. If we had not been able to get our transfer to Vietnam, we would have definitely died in Cambodia. I was living in District 10, in parenthesis, Boribo District, Kampong Chhnang Province, and everyone had to be transferred down to port at Kampong Liang District, Kampong Chhnang Province. When we were at the port, we saw that the Vietnamese people from Kaip Mountain District 16, in parenthesis, were also transferred from the mountain to the port. Everyone was forced to leave from Kaip Mountain, and it took us about one day to go from Kaip Mountain to the port. All the people who were transferred from District 10 and District 16 in Kampong Chhnang were placed in a boat to leave. All the people who were ill died along the way. There were many of us. I can't remember how many. We all just grouped together. We were grouped together, and then we left. We left Kampong Chhnang by boat at night time and passed up Phnom Penh on the way to Vietnam down the Tuen Le Sap River. There were about 7 or 8 Khmer Rouge cadre with us on the boat. I remember when we passed Phnom Penh, it was so dark at night, and I noticed there were no lights at all in Phnom Penh. Upon our arrival in Vietnam at around 4 p.m. the next day,
au Vietnam, le lendemain, aux alentours de 16
we were dropped at the coast, and the Vietnamese authorities came to collect
us.
I did not see any discussion between the Vietnamese authorities and the Khmer Rouge officials about the exchange of persons for rice and salt. Any agreement between the two authorities would have been reached beforehand. When we reached the border, they did another check, and anyone who was Khmer or Chinese had to stay on the boat and were not allowed to go onto the shore or coast. The Vietnamese were allowed to leave the boat. At the Cambodian-Vietnamese border, they controlled and identified who was Khmer and who was Vietnamese. They identified the Vietnamese from the Khmer because the Vietnamese spoke Vietnamese and Khmer spoke their own language. Mr. President, I will need 10 more minutes to conclude my presentation, or am I allowed only to present only the title of the document, or I may need time tomorrow
sinon je peux aussi prendre un moment
to present my key document, President.
Mon exposé,
so
President.
I will give you a bit more time tomorrow to
bien
present
demain, je vous donnerai davantage
your
de temps
key
pour
document.
Que vous
it is now appropriate time for the adjournment. The hearing will be resumed tomorrow on 24 February 2016 at 9 a.m. The chamber will continue to hear the presentation of key documents in relation to the treatment of the three targeted groups, Cham, Vietnamese, and official, former official of the Khmer Republic. And the defense team for Mr. Kyu Somphorn will have the opportunity to present the key document after the presentation by the lead co-lawyers for civil party security personnel are instructed to bring the two accused, Nguyen Chien and Kyu Somphorn, back to EC detention facility and have them returned into the courtroom tomorrow before 9 a.m. The court is now adjourned.